I am back and with some more Halo 2 Anniversary. We're on episode 3 of the Let's Play. I'm more or less continuing on from last episode. We did the Arbiter levels, the Heretic and... what was it? Heretic and the Oracle missions. And today we'll try and do Delta Halo. Depending on how long this is, like say this is 45 minutes, I might make this a shorter episode. This last episode was quite long. So I might break it up by making this just a little one. But I really enjoyed it. Last two episodes have been good. Like the levels in this have been so nice. And the gameplay, I think it is an improvement over Combat Evolved, definitely. Even that was a good gameplay system, but like they've done certain tweaks to this that really make it special. Like dual wielding, I just feel like an absolute tank when you using it. Hang on, cat, no, cat. Got a cat on me, so I got a bit of backup in case things go wrong. Hey? What's the matter, Bo? What's the matter?
Report!
Both engine cores have spun to zero. We're drifting. Archer pods are cold. I'll need to rekey the system.
Do it and find out where we are.
Sorry for the quick jump, Sergeant. You in one piece?
I'm good. Yeah. Chief?
We're fine.
Ma'am, there's an object coming into view now.
Cortana, what exactly am I looking at?
That is another Halo.
Say what?
So this is what my father found. I thought Halo was some sort of super weapon.
It is. If activated, this ring will cause destruction on a galactic scale. I want all the information you've got on the first Halo. Schematic,
topography, whatever. I don't care if I have the clearance or not.
Yes, ma'am.
Where's our target?
The enemy ship has stopped above the ring, ma'am. We're going to pass right over it.
Perfect. Given what we know about this ring, it's even more important that we capture the Prophet of Regret. Find out why he came to Earth, why he came here.
Chief, take first platoon. Hard drop. Secure a landing zone. Sergeant, load up two flights of Pelicans and follow them in.
Aye, aye, ma'am.
Until I can move and fight, I'm going to keep a low profile. Once you leave the ship, you're on your own.
Understood.
Over the target in 5.
Hang on to your helmet.
Was it 3 for 3 that did the cutscenes for the remaster? I assume they would. Whoever did the cutscenes for the remaster, like they are true Halo fans. Like, sorry. The cat's just getting comfy. It's weird that they did remove the assault rifle. It would have been cool. That's the only thing from Halo 2 that I am kind of missing, the classic assault rifle. just music. It's like a really casual. Never heard this music before. Well, I would have heard it. But... How have I already used my ammo? It's starting to sound more like Halo now. Sorry, you fucking cat. And my headset's getting in the way. Fuck you. It's weird that you just have you have a gun manufacturer like the assault rifle, and then it just vanishes off the face of the earth. Like they never use it again. Like it's strange. It's like that with a lot of the guns in Halo. Like the DMR that disappears and reappears constantly.
Starting our approach. Hang tight.
Actually, why haven't I got not? Ain't I got subtitles? Gameplay. Accessibility. Yeah, subtitles are on. You think the subtitles would be same for everything? Unless I missed one of them settings then. I wonder if I can blow it up. I've run out of bullets. Bullets, rockets, stabs. It's rockets. Fuck you. Chief, stop messing about, will ya? Ow. Leave me alone. I never thought the rocket launcher would last longer than this. I did just fucking blow. Man, I love that. I love double needles. It's crazy. I was doing that all last episode. I need to stop. It's so overkill for a grunt.
Another phantom on approach.
Let me just go. I don't want to just stick around there. There we go. What's stopping us from just leaving? Can we just leave? Why am I worrying myself over them guys for? I'm guessing this is the route we need to take, right? Oh.
Oh.
Man. The memories. Oh, wow, that. You didn't even notice that before. Ah, look how cool that is.
Let's wait for our warthog, unless you really want to walk.
Wanna go fight?
Here comes our ride.
A good view coming in. There's a big building in the middle of this island's lake.
I saw it too. It looked like a temple. If I were a megalomaniac, and I'm not, that's where I'd be.
Excuse me? Am I missing something? Ain't you meant to drop off a warthog here? Is it back here? I know I just ditched like the... Why? Okay. I was just chilling and enjoying the view.
Could you kill all those things? That would really be awesome!
I'm in, let's go!
It would have been safer for him to do it, like drop it off down here. I was just chilling and enjoying the view. Vehicle controls are so much better in this compared to like
threat neutralized.
Yeah, that's the way.
Look
out. That goes good.
Ah! Oh shit.
Hoorah.
Shit. Oh. I just got them guys killed. Creepy. The one thing I kind of like with this is the visual style hasn't changed too much between games. Like, it's slight, but like this is very similar to what it was. Isn't too complicated. I think they've done a better job with this. Oh, here we go. Terminal. I like these.
Regarding the history of the Covenant and its glorious founding species, the San Shayum and Sangheili, the record of punished deeds would not be sufficient without a word on the Arbiter. Not the consignment of shame that it is currently, but what came before, the legendary warriors of Sangheili past. Long before the Covenant, the Sangheili ruled their world with pride and vigilance, surviving the perils of both land and sea. These were the Arbiters of old, part king, part judge, warrior rulers, unlike any of which would follow. When we arrived on their frontier world of Ulgathon, the cost of life was severe. Led by a mighty Arbiter, the Sangheili resisted our entreatment with ruthless force, leading to decades of war. We would eventually triumph, of course. And when we did, we would not ignore the mantle of the Arbiter. Like all things, we would bend the Sangheili to our own ends. The Arbiters would become the very will of the Prophets.
Cool. Man, tell me that wouldn't be cool to have a game back. Set back in them periods, like where the Covenant was setting up, things like that. It'd be so interesting. Bullets, man. Everyone so died.
Welcome aboard.
This tank's gonna last long. It's already. The last time I used the tank, it almost died instantly.
Hey!
crazy how much firepower they have, you know? I would actually love a Halo game set by where you're in one of the old Arbiters and you're going through like the rebellion, or I don't know, something like that. So yeah, we haven't learned that much, even up until this point, about the Covenant. We've got everything about the UNSC and the human race, and like how they made the Spartans, but it'd be interesting to see how Covenant got like connected together, you know? I think a lot of people would like to see that. Because we know that we can play as an elite. For some reason, I'm just really sad it back in, I don't know why, but... It's like Star Wars in a way that you could go back and have like go back to the Clone Wars again if you want it.
Hey, careful!
Or like the Old Republic, things like that. For a movie. I wouldn't want Disney doing a movie on that, but if they wanted to. There's a lot of like untold stories. Yeah. Can you imagine like seeing something like this functioning? Kind of remind me of the palace in Mass Effect. They have some of this, but is it free?
Yeah. Hey, I got a live one!
I'm butchering this fucking fight. Bunches of Thank you. Well, maybe that. Oh, nice one. Just blew the fuck out of them. Oh, the DMR, man. I'm gonna go and get some more bullets.
Push them back.
We're running out of bullets. Might as well utilize it while I can. Oh, I ain't got to have I used this yet? I'm not sure whether I should use. It's a bit of an awkward combination because I can't aim for shit with either of these. I suppose I could switch out for it and a plasma rifle or something. I don't know where I'm going. There we go. I want to do all of these. I'm just giving him like a needle with like hardly any ammo in it. Try this out.
You always bring me to such nice places.
I like Krypton. I forget how kind of like I have had a good relationship for ages now. Even in Halo 1, they... Like, they
What's
had...
The Am I coming on
good banter.
Yeah!
You can run, but you can't hide.
Shoot it!
Is it dead? It's a dead.
Spotted another one.
Man, I like the sound of this. The sniper in this. But then it does have that classic sound, which is good as well. I don't remember Halo 3 enough. This makes a good soundtrack. They probably reused a lot of it. Very nice. Yeah, sniper isn't that strong. Kind of sniper in the lead in the end. Demon flare? That's your flare.
Got anything else you want to say?
Look up here first. Nothing. Okay, the one thing I like that I must have watched some of the terminal videos. Like, they're actually really cool. I think I've seen them a few times. I think I've watched them all in a YouTube video, but I must have seen them when I played through the game, because they're
good. Still no word about any number clad on the Covenant battle net.
They're quite easy.
It's
they're,
odd.
They're not that.
The Covenant know we made landfall, but they don't seem to consider us a very serious threat. Boy, are they in for a big surprise.
I have missed some, I think, but yes, cool. I like this stuff. It's just a ship in the distance. Oh man, hey, Bungie used to do such a good job. Let's see, even good back then. Like, they have improved. Oh, actually, yeah, it's not too much difference really. Even in this, they were trying to do stuff like with the foliage and everything. What are you doing, Sunshine? Sorry. I don't know why, but my cat, I don't know whether anyone else is this, my cat keeps getting his tongue stuck. Like, sticking out. I'm not sure why he does it. Like, it's after he's cleaned it, he's sticking his tongue out, and it's like, he won't put it back. Like, the other day I found him dribbling everywhere.
Watch yourself. Honor guard.
Ah. Fuck. Fucking hell. Man, that's cool. You wanna go? Shit! Like, because there's a whole different world with the Covenant. It'd be kinda cool to explore them in a game. Like, he's a fucking moron, isn't he? Alright, we'll do this next episode. This next mission, I weren't sure. It's only 37 minutes, so we'll do the next episode. Next mission. Yeah. And I'm enjoying myself. Too much to quit now.
Wait, go back. That's what I thought he said. The Prophet of Regret is planning to activate Halo.
Are you sure?
I shall light this holy ring, release its cleansing flame, and burn a path into the divine beyond.
Pretty much.
Commander, we've got a problem.
So I hear. But from what I understand, the Prophet will need an object, the Index, to activate the ring. I've located a library similar to the one you found on the first Halo. If the rings work the same way, the Index should be inside.
I'll bet the Covenant are thinking the exact same thing.
Then we better beat them to it, Sergeant. Extract your men and meet me at the library.
Yes, ma'am.
I'll secure the Index, Chief. You take out the Prophet. He's given us all the intel we need.
Dude, just go give up.
Just give me a second.
You made that look easy.
It's a bit quieter in the odd game. Oh, the audio isn't as good. Well, it's good in a way, but it's not. It's crazy what they were able to do back in the day when you think about it. My developers moan about how hard it is to create a game now. I could only imagine what it's like creating a game back in the day.
I think the Forerunners built these new structures around the old to protect them, honor them. Pure speculation, mind you. I need to make a thorough survey to be sure.
But if it weren't for them developers making games like this back in the day, we probably wouldn't have half the games we have now. Fuck you, I was shooting at then. Hey, he let you drop his rifle and gave up when I got near him. That's kind of interesting. Because it was like the AI knew that he weren't going to get a shot on me otherwise.
Contact.
Ooh, is this a terminal? I'm just looking out for that. Oh, for a collectible, going after terminals with like a lore video. Man, that's so much better than like in Fallout 76, where you get a terminal and it's just a load of text with loads of bollocks written on it. It's just a completely different vibe. It's like so much effort put into creating a whole like animation to show off a bit of lore behind the scenes. It's, I wish all games did that in a way. It feels way more like, it seems way more like, entertaining. It doesn't stop you from playing the game. It just feels so slow in Fallout 76. In all the, a lot of the Fallouts I've played before, or like learning the lore is hard, difficult, I'd say, in Fallout 76 or any of the Fallout games, because same with Skyrim, I suppose. Like, it's just like, I don't know. You've got to really take, like, you've got to explain it in it, all these little documents all over the place, and I find that annoying. Like, I don't play a game to spend most of my time reading. Am I missing something? My door's open, but like learning the lore on in Halo, with like clips on the history and everything, I think it's way cooler. What am I missing? There's always moments like these in the Halo games where I'm like, oh, here we go. Thank you, guys. Could have told me I'm going the wrong way. Instead of you guys having all the fun. I love the fuckers, I bet you. Now, don't we get some... Don't we have hunters spawn in there? Yeah. I think we get two hunters.
You don't rage!
That's right, yeah!
Ah! Ah! Right, these are. Careful, mate. You're gonna hurt someone. I kind of fucked himself over, didn't he?
Cortana, the Covenant's getting nosy. I don't want to give away my position, so I'm rerouting a few stragglers back to you. I apologize. These Pelicans are all the support you're gonna get. Understood, ma'am.
rings off center, any?
A gondola is launching from the far towers. Big surprise, it's full of Covenant reinforcements.
Oh. Do you want a shotgun? Yeah, we'll stick with this for now.
Oh, go fuck yourself. You're in the way. Fuck that. I gotta need that. You got anything I want?
This lake couldn't have been formed by volcanic action, which means it was either built this way on purpose or was created by some other cataclysmic event. Oh, sorry. Were you trying to kill something?
Not that powerful in this compared to this one hit headshot. Wonder why they nerfed it. I say they nerfed it. It's probably because of the multiplayer maybe, but I assume it's different, I suppose, like compared to like, I don't know. I think they'd keep the powerful sniper. Well, they do amend it, because, in Reach, it was pretty strong. It's alright against them guys, but you can kill them guys with bloody sneeze. So fucking good. Let's do that. Suppose that weren't a double then. We
What are you wasting ammo for, you dumbass? The real target's down here. Why can't I switch my grenades?
Run, get ready, man!
And that was one weird thing I saw about Infinite, is that kill animations, you know, like in Halo Reach where you go up behind someone and you take them down that way? They won't be in Halo Infinite. And it's like it's not the end of like the end of the world if they don't add assassinations, because it's not like that big of a deal, but it's just another thing that they've said that it's gonna be after. And I'm really getting annoyed of 343 constantly. We're finally getting Halo Infinite news, and they keep coming up with excuses for things that aren't going to be in the game at launch. And it's just—it's not the publicity that should be saying to the game. They should be saying, it should be the opposite. They should be saying, "Oh yeah, we got because they've delayed the game," and they should be saying, "Oh yeah, assassinations are going to be at launch." What they should have done is said, we're delaying the game again, but we're going to make sure that there's assassinations at launch.
There's a submerged forge at launch, these towers co-op to the at launch, structures.
Stuff like that, instead of them just
looks
saying
like we're going down. Unless you
these things aren't
going
to be at launch. Because it's just, it's not good news. I don't know why. Because they've been supporting the Master Chief Collection quite well. If they could keep doing like some content for this in the meantime, I have a small team just saying, "Oh, is that fucking Widows?" You made out of your little. Well, this guy's a trooper. You ain't dying for no one. Ain't much as a. Yeah, we'll do that. Yeah, I don't. I'm the new, like the recent news for Infinite. I ain't liking it because it should be the opposite, where they're like really saying like they're making the best Halo game, and when they're constantly saying that it's not, it is bothering. Like it bother anyone that likes the Halo games.
I've intercepted a secure transmission from Regret's carrier to something called High Charity. It seems to be a formal apology to the prophets of truth and mercy. Apparently, Regret jumped the gun when he attacked Earth. He's asking the other prophets to forgive his premature arrival, arguing that no human presence was foretold. That explains why there were so few ships in his fleet. But it's odd a prophet would have such bad intel about his enemy's homeworld.
So honestly, I wouldn't mind a Halo game if it looked like this still. I know that's really weird for me to say, but I'd rather have good gameplay over like things that, like, if graphics are affecting the game and the gameplay and co-op and all that stuff. I think Halo 5 we didn't have split screen co-op because the game couldn't handle it, because it was, they were trying to push the graphics too much, and I'd rather have game look like this than not have like the classic features. What the fuck happened to you? What happened to my needler? Of course it fell down a gap. Have your shotgun then, mate. I don't know. Maybe they'll delay it, I don't know. We've got the 8th of December till the game comes out, so I suppose we'll see what they do with it, but there's a good chance they might delay it again, but I think it would be better for the game if it was delayed. Because they even know when Forge and that will be finished. They said 6 months, so why don't you just delay 6 months? I know it'd be bad for like people that do YouTube on Halo and everything, but it's only positive for the game
now
at the end of the day.
Schooling.
I think. But I need to stop ranting about it, but it's just bothering me all the news about Infinite. Every news story is about content that they're not going to put in. It's going to be after, and it's... Even though most of the content that I'm not going to be too focused on, it's the story that I'm more interested in. But at this rate, they're going to say the campaign's going to be released 6 months later. We're just gonna get the multiplayer. I'm surprised that they ain't done that yet. Mate, he fucking failed, didn't he? He was just chilling. Funny how he had his weapon drawn. Whoa. Man. Oh shit. Fuck you.
Fear my face.
Ow. They have changed up the hunters a bit, because in Halo Combat Evolved you could get in the face a bit more. Yes! That's so cool. That felt like one of them cutscenes then. You know where Chief's like just doing a backflip on a hunter? I think it's like Halo 4 or something. He's just jumping over like hunters and not getting it. That's fun. I like that.
And people say I've got a big head.
On our search, were compelled to join our union, to take part in a movement that promised freedom for allegiance, salvation for service. But some, like the humans, chose to impede our progress, block our access,
not get happy,
sacred
sites, people.
Damage holy relics. For their transgressions, the humans shall be hunted until none remain alive.
He's finished. Yeah, I would love a Covenant game. Arbiter. That stuff. I think it'd be great. What have you got? Imagine if you could dual wield energy swords. That'd be awesome. You with energy swords, that'd be another level. Why did you do that? So the thing is, like, Arbiter, he had a cloak ability. Which makes sense, so like, it's... You wouldn't expect Chief to have, like, active camo. I kind of like how they've got that difference. Oh my god. Is there a way to remove the water? Because it's kind of making things slow. Oh no, it's not. Is that me Renee? Crouching? Yeah, that's me crouching. I was like, why is it making me slow? Fucking cut you, mate. Cut you up, mate. Little fucker. Who thought it'd be a good idea to give Grunt invisibility is like the gremlins? Where did he go? Oh god. He's just running around as well, invisible. I think a grunt that's been given the ability to go invisible would have the balls. This is reminding me of Bioshock.
Regret's carrier just received a response from High Charity. A very well encrypted message from the Prophet of Truth. Listen to this. Your haste has jeopardized the fulfillment of our covenant, threatened our grand design. That you shall be spared a public display of our contempt is thanks only to Mercy and his wise counsel. Truth, Mercy, Regret. Three Prophet Hierarchs. Killing Regret should shake up the Covenant leadership, but frankly, it sounds like you might be doing Truth a favor.
Yeah, I wonder if, like, the people that made Bioshock either took inspiration from that level, like, this old idea. I mean, it's not that connected, but, like, the whole... Being transported through underwater, like an underwater city almost. Fucking get wrecked, boys. So bright, it's weird. In Halo Combat Evolved, it was like darker.
Every member of the Covenant shall walk the path. None will be left behind when our great journey begins. That is the Prophet's age-old promise, and it shall be fulfilled.
Great journey? Doesn't he know what these rings do?
Well, it's weird. It's like, In Combat Evolved, the remaster was always lighter than the original game, whereas in this, it's somewhat the opposite. Oh. Oh, fuck. Come on, boys, stop. I don't know why they call it Demon Flare.
This is my last run, Chief. I'm nearly out of fuel. We secured the first tower cluster, so I'll set down there. Call when you're ready for evac.
Oh, you dropped them shit, didn't you, mate? Let's see what we got. I did like the shotgun.
Sir!
Man, why has he dropped them like this? Come on, boys, let's go. See? They dropped them all off to just get slaughtered instantly. Oh, that was fun. It'd be cooler if they did a firefight for Halo 2. I'll probably play this all day. Like, gameplay is that good. Back on the elevator. Took my bullets. I will keep that. Shame you didn't drop all them other ones on here. That would have been better. Keep moving. I'll finish up this level and recall it.
So far, so good. We're approaching the main temple now. Roger that. I'm as close to the library as I can get. There's some sort of barrier. We're trying to find a way around it. I'll keep you posted.
That's why they wanted rocket launchers. Feels like some of them shot some in.
Rocket boy.
Don't stand in front of me, you dumb. What the? he just
was like, I had enough for life. I'm standing in front of Chief's bullets.
How many medals did Chief get at the end of all this?
That's the largest Covenant fleet I've ever seen. The largest anyone's ever seen. Get inside the temple and kill Regret before it can stop us.
Oh, it's kind of cool, like, you can imagine, like, after all this, Chief going to every single family I've killed. All the family soldiers that he accidentally killed.
Stay with them!
Except to say sorry. I think he should. How many families I've ruined by just shooting them by accident. It's cool, like, the whole
jewel with it, like, you can change it up so much. Multiple waves of phantoms. Too many for me to track. We don't have much time. There are honor guards all over this place. Watch your back.
Ah, fuck! Thanks, Cortana. Honor guards. Oh, he's so fucking. I remember this area. Well, you fucking camping prick. You're just sitting in a corner. Of course he ain't there now.
There's the target. Take him out.
Don't die, don't die. Ow. Man, he's pretty good. He got kitted out.
Incompetence! I'll kill it myself!
Ah, fuck you! Yeah, get the fuck out of here, boy. Oh no!
You think you hide from me?
Ah! I'm dead.
Is shielded. It's deflecting everything you throw at it. Get in close and do whatever you can.
Ah! Warriors, attack!
Run! Well, you wouldn't think that would do anything. Throwing up and smacking? Or is it because I didn't do that right? Ain't I meant to board him? I start punching him in the face? I remember something like that happening. Oh, that's it. There we go. Friendship.
Americans are turning around. The fleet is preparing to fire on our position. We need to get out of here. Sacred icon. I guess we'll end it here for today because that's a good place to end. I'm glad I did the extra effort level. It's been fun today. I did today's episode and last episode. So I played quite a bit today. I think I'll play some more tomorrow. We'll do that next time. Oh man, I love the cutscenes are so good. Like, you can't really be, I've not seen any games that have have done the game that well. In the idea of just how clean it looks. It looks like how Halo should look in as a next gen game. And maybe not the gameplay is next gen, but the visuals of the gameplay. But even that, I'd rather the game look like it does remastered than say when it's like something like Halo 5 or something, and it affects what they can do with the game. When they're more worried about frame rates and stuff, and I think that's more of a problem for games sometimes. I think. When you focus more on the graphics, I think it does affect what you can create sometimes. I couldn't imagine State of Decay 2 or State of Decay in general working if they went all graphics and all fun, really good realistic graphics for State of Decay. I really think the gameplay would suffer a lot. I admit, the gameplay ain't great for State of Decay in a way, but the combat is quite. It's its own thing, and I think if it went more highly graphics live, I think they would copy someone else. Whereas with State of Decay, they're not worried about the graphics or the way the game. They try and do their best, but they're not going for
the most prettiest game ever. They're putting gameplay before everything else, and I think that's what games should be doing. Because we never worried about graphics back in the day. Like, sure, it's always improved and it always will, but I don't think it's important for games. I think it's the gameplay and the story. I think if anything, if you want the visuals to be good looking, do it in the cutscenes. Because like, even though the graphics in this remaster, like, the gameplay looks different from the cutscenes, I still feel connected to both. Like, it's not a massive disconnect. The cutscenes are way prettier in that than the gameplay, but it doesn't affect. Like, the gameplay is still the games lately is more fun than the actual cutscenes in a way, because you don't play the cutscenes, you just watch them. And I think you should make the cutscenes as enjoyable as the gameplay. But yeah, it's been good. So there'll be more Halo tomorrow and the day after. And yeah, check out State of Decay. I should have started that up yesterday, and there should be one up today. Then tomorrow we'll probably be back with Grounded or something. And yeah, I don't think there's a house. Yeah, I'm gonna leave it for today. So yeah, I don't think there's a house. Yeah, I'm gonna leave it here. As always, thanks for watching if you've been watching, and I'll see you all in the next one.